All right, name of the Father and Son and Holy Spirit, come God be me. Today we talk about Pope Peter, number 17, the last martyrs, and the problem with Arius when the story of Arius happening. We start off his story with, he was a very talented person. Pope Peter, number 17, last martyrs. We mention him in commemoration. We mention him in every commemoration, and even Abuna, when he gives the absolution, they give absolution from the mouth of St. John Chrysostom and all, or and St. Peter, St. Discourse, St. Athanasius, St. Peter, last martyrs. So that means one of the book very important. And we will see why they call him last martyrs. He was the Pope number 17. His dad was a priest, his name is Theodosius. His mother, her name is Sophia. And they've been long time, they have no kids. When the feast of St. Paul and Peter come, and Abuna was doing La'an, washing people's feet, everyone have little kids, so the mother stand on the picture of St. Peter and Paul, start to cry with tears, please, I need a child. They appear here in the same night and told her, you will have a child, and this child will be blessed with the child, and he looking after a lot of people. So, and they go to the Pope in that time, his name Pope Sauna, number 16, go and they tell him about this dream. She went, he prayed for her. So, another year, in the day of the feast of St. Peter and Paul, she got birth to the baby. And she went to the Pope to call him, he said, because the message from St. Peter and Paul, and because you got the baby in the feast of Peter and Paul, we can call him Peter. This boy, he was very talented and smart. When he was 5 years old, he was learning to read and write, and he read even some books. When he was 7 years old, they ordinate him as a deacon, Ognostos, and when he was 12 years old, he was consecrated as a full deacon, 12 years old. When he was 16, the Pope, he found him very smart, he spoke very good, he ordained him a priest at 16 years old. And he make him the priest preaching on the cathedral. After he was the priest, someone he started to say the three hypostases is different. The Father, it's a higher, the Son, it's lower than him, and the Holy Spirit separate. And they mixing up, so the Pope, he wasn't happy about this heresy. He sent Abu Father Peter to go talk to him, and he explained him the right way. Another time, people coming to the church, they found someone possessed by demons, threw rocks on them. So the Pope, he told them to go to heal this person. He got some water and told the Pope to send the cross in this water out of his humbleness. The Pope sent the cross. He took the water, threw it in this person. The demon possessed went out. The Pope, the owner getting older, so people when before he died were very upset. Our Father, why you leave us? And so he said, I'm not going to leave you. There's Father Peter after me, he will be next Pope. They ordained him a Pope in year 302, in January. In that time was the persecution of the Diocletians, or Diocletia, what they call him? Diocletia? Diocletians. Diocletian, yeah, Diocletian. It was the persecution of Diocletian. But this, he thought Diocletian closed the church, burning the Bible, burning the books, and was big persecution in Alexandria. So the Pope in that time, and a lot of, he left his cathedral, and they started preaching in Upper Egypt, a small village, to encourage people to be strong on the faith. He writes a very important book against the people believe in idols. And one of the reasons, the Diocletian, he won't kill him. And another point, this Diocletian, his right hand, his wife, her name Sarah, she got two kids. She wanted to baptize them. Her husband was a Christian, but because Diocletian, he left the Christianity and he persecuted the Christianity, he followed him. So she told them, we need to baptize our kids. He said, no, we're not going to baptize, he cannot kill us. She took the kids and went to Alexandria. During when she was in the boat, was a very strong wind and rain, and the boat nearly sinking in the water. So she cut herself and get some of the blood, signed the cross on the kids and baptized them. After this, the boat went to arrive to Alexandria, and was the 6th week of the Great Lent, the week of the blind man, they call the baptism week or something in tradition of the church. They collect all the kids' meat to baptize in that day, and they baptize them. 100, 200. I remember in Egypt, we have big queue, and we have one deacon's right name, give certificate, and the priest, 1, 2, 3, and give another priest to put holy iron. 1, 2, 3, huge, 400, 600 kids in that day. So, she got her kids to the Pope to baptize them. The Pope baptized everyone normal. He got the kids to put them on the water be like rock. Take the kids out, the water come back. He baptized another one, should be alright. Get her kids back, he found the water like rocks. He told the deacon, get me the mother of these kids. The mother come, the Pope told her, what did you do? She said, what happened about the boat nearly sink? That's why I was worried they died without baptism. That's why I cut myself some blood, I made cross and baptized them. He said, that's why we have only one baptism, and God accepted her baptism. That's why he doesn't want the kids to be baptized again. In that time, Arius, the heresies, like Jehovah Witness now, start to appear on this history. He starts to say the father is higher than the son, and with time the father is there and there is no son, and the father, he created the son. We say our church believes the father and son, Holy Spirit, one God. He said no, there is different between the father and son. So the Bob Peter in that time, who was very angry, he got him and started to explain him once, twice. He didn't listen to him, he excommunicated him. But unfortunately, he was from that. He was priest of our church of Alexandria. But he be educated from the people coming from the school of Antioch. School of Antioch, there was philosophy. They treat the religion like they treat philosophy. They cannot have dialogue. They cannot discuss it. They cannot argue. They talk it as a subject, not as a religion. That's why you found Nestor was from school of Antioch. Macedonius were from school of Antioch, and all these people, heresies, was from school of Antioch. Our school of Alexandria, they consider the theology as a religion and the Bible as a religion, not as a book. After this, the persecution started getting more and harder and harder. This Sarah with her two kids went back to her husband. Her husband told the king about she baptized the kids, so the king decreed and he killed her. So Sophia or Sarah and her two kids, and they martyr. When the Diocletian, he know St. Peter the Pope, he write books against the paganism, and he baptized his right hand man wife. He said he sent the government to arrest him. The government arrested him and he put him in jail. And they said we cannot kill him after 1 or 2 days. All the Christian people was around the jail, and they said if you cannot kill him, you kill all of us. And there was a big fight between the soldier of the Roman Empire and the Christian in Alexandria. And that night, there's two disciples of the Pope Peter coming to visit him at jail. And Arius, when them, they started to cry with him, I said, I back to normal faith, I'm wrong, I back to normal faith, and he start say, you're right, I wrong, so they deceived him. So they went to ask Bob for absolution for Arius. They found the Bob get very angry and said he never can be come back to the church. And he told them, don't you think I'm hard on him? No. Last night when I was sleeping, Jesus appeared to me and his clothes cut in two. And I told him, who cut your clothes? He said, Arius, because he separated me from my father. That's why he told his two disciples, first one, you Archelaus, you be above after me. And you, Alexandros, you be the Bob after him. And I tell you, do not let Arius to come to the church. And St. Peter, Bob Peter, he found a lot of noise outside. The Christian want him out, the Roman soldier, they doesn't want him out, they want to kill him. He found his people, the Christian, they can get injured and get killed. He told the head of the soldier, I will knock back my cell, you hear from which side, you open from the back and I can go out. So at night they knocking back, so the head of the soldier hear from which side he go. So back to the building, they got him out, and everyone waiting outside on the prison, they thinking he will come. So he went out. When he was walking in the area of San Marcos Market, He told him, can you let me pray? They said, all right, pray. When he prayed, he said, God, please, I ask you to be my blood, last blood of and the end of the persecution. He heard a voice from heaven and said, Peter was the first as a disciple, and you cannot be Peter, the last of martyrs on the beginning era. And there was, that's why we call him Pope Peter, last martyrs. He went and he beheaded, and when people discover he being beheaded and the martyr, they took him to the church and put him in the throne, because he never sit down in his chair as a Pope, because he said, every time I come to sit down, I will see some mark sit down, and who I am can sit down on the place of some mark. What happened after his departure? Archelaus be a Pope, and Archelaus Arius, he deceived him and asked him to come back. He allowed him to come back. He stayed the shortest one ever Pope on the throne of Alexandria. He stayed only 6 months. And he died because he bring Arius back and he didn't listen to his father. And after him, Pope Alexandros, he coming, and he was the Pope number 19. And because Pope Peter 17, Archelaus 18, Pope Alexandros number 19, and he's the one excommunicate Arius again. And he's the one in his time was the Nicaea, the Council of Nicaea, and was the famous deacon with him who sent Athanasius, the one he cannot be the Pope number 20 after him. And the Nicaea, the Council of Nicaea was all about the heresies, mostly of Arius, because he says the father not equal to the son. Any question about this? Alright? Thank you very much. In the name of the Father and Son and the Holy Spirit, one God, Amen. Now, Joshua, I want to hear, please. I will talk about 5 minutes about what's a deacon and the rank of deacon, and after this, about 15 minutes about our church. Okay? How many level of deacons we have in our Orthodox Church? Five. Okay. What's the first one? Absolved. Yeah, what is
singer?
What he has to sing?
The
hymn and alhan and very good. What about if the deacon outside here doesn't sing his hymns or the hymns in the mass? He doing his job? He not doing his job. So what about the word deacons? What are the deacons? Normal deacons. Normal deacon, the word deacon, yes, James. Normal word deacon, that's a Syrian word from language, Syrian language, they call a servant. A servant. So deacon or shaman, it's a servant word in, we take it from the Syrian language, and in English they translate as a deacon. So a deacon, a servant. So if you are a psalmist, your job to say the hymn. So if you're not doing the hymns with the manual outside or Ehab or anyone, you're not doing your job. Number two, after the Exaltus or Nostos? Reader. What's the reader? What he has to read? What about when the deacons call inside, let the readers read the name of our Holy Father, the Baptist? Who has to read this one? In early church, the readers, the Onostos, they divide the 116 bow in each other, and after this, the deacon tells everyone he reads his part. So they have to mention all the name of the 116 bow. And some of the church, if you go, you find them, they put in the wall the name of the 116 previous bow. And the Onostos, he must read it. If they do see Onostos inside, they have to read it. What about the Exaltus? Exaltus. What he wearing? Just he allowed to wear any batashim? No. Good. What about the agnostus? Light cross, like the San Stephen. Yeah, that's very good. Light cross. The church says the agnostus, then exaltus first coming from the word of psalmos, that means mazmur. And when the bishop ordained him, he not have to put his hand or cut his hair. only by word. He said, you are Michael, we ordinate Kipsaltos in the church of St. George, and that's enough for him to be a deacon. Agnostic must be 18 years old or above, unless some circumstances, unless if he's too good, unless if the church recommend him because he's good, or unless the church needs some agnostics to ordinate them to help in the service. Kipsaltos not allowed to touch any thing from used in the altar, even with tower, even with anything. Kipsaltos. Agnostics, he allowed touch it, but he has to have tower in his hand, like when he dries the, you know, the plate and the spoon and all the stuff. Agnostics must be 18 years and must be a very good reader on the Bible. In early days, the Bible, in only 15 centuries, they start to make the verse number 1 in chapter 1, verse number 2, number 3. But the Agnostics in that time, he takes the books of the church at home and he starts tomorrow reading, he mark it, so the deacon coming to read, he know where he can stop. So that was his job, to do the reading for next day, so he know reading the Bible very well. And he used to be to preaching people like we do in the mass, you see some deacons coming, that's part of his job. Part of his job too, to know the tazbeha, part of his job. And when he served as a deacon, he knows the reading, he can preach, and no any servant allowed to give servant to be a servant unless he be minimum agnostics. I remember when I was in theological college, the Pope asked us, did anyone here not a deacon? Anyone not a deacon, he make a mass, a special mass, and he ordinate everyone minimum agnostics. Minimum to be agnostics to cannot serve. Alright? The bishop ordinate him by cutting his hair how many times? Five times. One, two, three, four, and one of the middle, like the cross. Why five times? Because the five wounds of Jesus Christ. Three knives, one spear, and the crown of thorns. And he wears the barbashin like St. Stephen. After this one, after Kipsaltos or Agnostics, who after this? Epiziakon. What means Epiziakon? Subdeacon. And this minimum age to be at 20 years old. Minimum age. And he wears the badrashin. Some people they said similar to the cross. Some people they said he wear it in right hand, like Stephen right hand. But to be a deacon, he wear it in left hand. But some books I found, they said he can wear it like St. Stephen. Okay, we don't have much Epiziakon in our church. Which one? No one else? I think Peter Morris. Yeah, Peter Morris. Okay, after the Epiziakon, we got Diakon. In Diakon, we have a little problem here. Why? To be a deacon, you must wear full black, and you have not another job to allow to get the blood. That's your job. You consecrate your life to be a deacon in the church. That's your job. It's a servant. And in Egypt, he takes pay from the church, and that's his job. I remember when I was in the theological college, we have made the one previous one, he used to hold the cover, gold cover for the Pope. So he must have no another job, his job, to work in the church, he get paid, and he wearing a black when he do any service. And he not doing any service outside, only his service to be a servant on the church. And with permission from the bishop of the diocese or the priest, he allowed to get blood if the abuna allowed him to do this. Alright, that's for diakon. Yes, George. I can't comment. I teach you here the right way. What happened outside, I can't comment. You understand my point? I tell you what I read in my book and what I learned from the theological college. We have only one deacon in Egypt, Rojti. He was, during I was in theological deacon in Egypt, he have PhD in theology, and he or they ordinate him as a deacon, and he teach in political college, and he has nothing outside job that his job teach in political college, he get paid, even he not giving a plus. Okay, so I don't know what happened, but that's what the law of the church. Okay, what happened after, maybe they take permission from the Pope, something like this, because the shortage breed, I can't comment, it's something they call it special. Like the law of the church says, Onostos be 18 years. We have here, he was 13, 12 years old, was Onostos. What happened here, some exception, but not all the time. We say that, we say the right way, but what happened outside, that some exception happened. Alright, just a quick about the five level of the deacons. We got deacon and after this archdeacon, number five, archdeacon. I don't think we have any in Sydney here. Maybe in overseas some of the dioceses they organize archdeacon, but we don't have it here. Even Ma'alim Ibrahim, he's not archdeacon. He's just a deacon and wearing a deacon uniform. Sometimes when he do a formal service with the Pope. Alright? That's quick about the level of the deacons. Why? Because you deacon, you need to know your job. You need to know why you're here for. Another point I want to talk about the church. To design a church, we have three design you cannot design the church. Which design you think the church should be designed for? Noah's Ark. Why Noah's Ark? No. Why Noah? Why we choose the shape of Noah's Ark? Because that's very good. Because people inside the boat or the ark, what happened to them? Say, what about the people outside? So the church teach you, if you want to get saved, you have to be inside, not the first shape. What about second shape? No, design of the design of the church. Second shape? Round like Urbana. Yeah, right, Urbana. Why it have to be round? No, Ark is a different design. Another design the church can be round. That's good. And the salvation, yeah, put your hand up please. And the salvation of God have no end. Beginning or end. The salvation of God, he covers everyone. Number three, the design of the church like cross. Because without a cross, no salvation. And this three design I saw it myself in Egypt was nice design, some design on the cross, some design like Urbana, and some design like Noah Ark. Okay. Imagine if you go to the heaven. Look like the ark. Because in overseas it's very hard to follow the design because sometimes you have to bend this size. Okay? But St. Mary looks like no ark because they built it from scratch. Alright, what about if we go to heaven? Who we can see? Number one, Jesus. Who else do you see? Saints. What else we can see in heaven? Angels. Yeah, very good. So, yeah, we can see all the time, not including the time. So if your friends is not going to go to heaven, if they your friends. Now let us concentrate another 10 minutes and we'll finish. If we're going to go to heaven and we see Jesus, we see the saints, we see the angels. If we see them in the church, so what this tell us? The church is the heaven. And some of the church, you look to the top, maybe Uncle Seher saw some of the church like this in Egypt, he found some stars and big picture of Jesus in the middle. Because the stars represent this the heaven. Inside? No. Star was... Yeah, no, but I talking about the ceiling, like you look to the ceiling like you are in the heaven. Yes, that's the right design. Again, because we are in overseas, they can't design exactly. They design on the side of the building. It's more restricted, but Egypt, they have bigger land, they can design. So when you go to Egypt, you find exactly the design by the Coptic church. Yes, yeah. Yes, he found Jesus in the middle. Yes, that's correct way. And some of the church, they put it in the star because that represents the heaven. All right. So, did Jesus coming in the altar? Wind.
In the altar.
Wind in the altar. I can't take someone. You put your hand up and tell me. Yes, yes, and yes. Yes, what else? He coming during the Holy Spirit winter. Then in the altar, he changing what to be what and he changing what to be what?
Wine.
Your hand up? Yes.
The thing is the bread of blood is the wine is body and blood.
The wine to be a blood and the bread to be a body of Jesus Christ. After this, something Abuna he do, and always we have to look. Abuna he do something. Abuna before the Holy Spirit come, he stands the cross in everyone. This Jew and stand the cross. But after the Holy Spirit come, what Abuna do? He not allow it. He just make like this, because he let Jesus himself to bless. If Jesus ascend, that means number one, if we go heaven, we see Jesus, if we see in the altar, we see Jesus. One of the story, a priest was doing the mass, and they found him during the mass, he stopped. The deacon, he think, Abuna, he forgot his start, tell Abuna, Abuna, continue this word, and tell him the word, Abuna, quiet, Abuna, 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 very quiet. For how long? 7 minutes. So after the mass finished, the deacon come to Abuna. Abuna, why you stop? He said, did anyone notice? He said, yes, Abuna was about 7 minutes. He said, what? For me, it looks like second. I was starting praying. I found the ceiling of the altar open. I see Jesus himself blessing everyone in the church. Abuna, he said like second, but the deacon he recognized was 7 minutes. So Jesus coming himself on the altar and during the mass to blessing his people. And when we have Holy Communion, we take the body and blood of Jesus Christ. So number one, we can see Jesus Christ on the church, and in the same Jesus Christ, when we go upstairs, we see him. So that's number one, the church is heaven. Number two, when you go to heaven, you will see the angel. Did we see the angel in the church? If the deacon do their job good and respect themselves, maybe we can be angel. But the angel can come to the church. Abuna Mikhail Ibrahim, Abuna Mikhail Ibrahim, one day he was, you know, the part Abuna starts getting the paper and everyone writes for him, please Abuna, I have exam. Please Abuna, remember me, I sick. Please Abuna, my dad, this. Please Abuna, I need to find job. And all this paper Abuna reads. Abuna Mikhail Ibrahim, he starts reading, and they found little deacon go up and down, go up and down. He told him, stop. So this deacon, one of the big deacon, took him in the side, tell him, stop here, don't move. The mass finished, they found him after the mass, Abuna gets his, this little deacon, and he make matani in front of him, in front of everyone. So the priest tell him, Abuna, what you doing? You are 75 years and this like one of the, your grandchildren. You make matanya in front of the church for him? He said yes. So Abuna second, Abuna let everyone go and they take Abuna on the side, tell him, Abuna, tell me what happened. He said, no, I'm not going to tell you. He started, I said, Abuna, please tell me what happened. He said, I can tell you, but don't tell anyone until I go up. That means until I pass away. He said, every time I was mentioned and remember one name, the angel of God coming, take his paper names and go up. Every time I mention name, the angel coming, take the name and go up. Every time, go up. When he's going up and down and talking, stop, I found the angel never come back. That's why I want to apologize to this deacon, so next time the angel of God come back. And remember, end of the night, Abuna, he said, the angel of this day, yes, the angel not allowed to leave the altar and take the prayer and this sacrifice until Abuna gave him permission. To show you, if Abuna didn't give him permission, they're not allowed to leave.
The angel.
The because Abuna must give him permission to go take the prayer and sacrifice to go and remember us in front of the Lord. Another story, with three deacon, they being ordained new. They want to serve in one of the church in Egypt. They said, all right, we're going to bring this church. We can go together at night, the church will go. So they went to the church. One of them, they told others, we just knew deacons, we don't know anything. He said, don't worry, when we got a lot of deacons. They go to the church, they found Abuna sit outside, waiting for any deacon to come. Abuna asked him, you are a deacon? Yes, Abuna. Thank God, come with me. You sit outside, and both of you come with me inside. Abuna already left half an hour, he needs to start. Abuna started to do the mass, and said the deacon answer. What? He looked at his friend. They don't know. Abuna starts the mass. He told the one outside, come inside. Abuna starts to answer in and out by himself and the deacon, everything. And they come and start the mass. He comes to Awashi. Remember the book Abuna, he said in Coptic. They start laughing. They can't say anything. They can't do anything. What happened? They found a little light coming from up, like ball light, and they stand on front of them, and they found this light like silver, and they start to shape as angel. The three look to the picture, and they stop. After the mass, one of them stands, tell Abuna, can I talk to you? And tell him, Abuna, we was laughing, we saw this. Second one sit with Abuna, tell him, Abuna, we was laughing, we saw this. Third one was laughing and we saw this. To show you, inside the altar, God, he wanted to show them a little bit what's inside the altar. This is not the place for joke or for laughing. Okay? So number one, we see Jesus. Number two, we see the angel. Last story about the angel, to show you the church angel appear and ascend all the time. During the first role of the late Pope, he used to 4 o'clock, 3 o'clock in the morning, go in the church, knock the door, and make that back. So one of the church, he knocked the door and went in, he found the deacon, he's doing tazbah. This deacon, mostly of the deacon and ma'alimin, be blind in Egypt. Mostly they go to Didymus, Institute of Didymus, for people blind to learn Al-Han, and they work as a ma'alimin for Kinesi. So the Pope comes with his disciple and the driver coming to the church, they hear the ma'alim doing tazbah and someone else responds. Ma'alim respond in Coptic, someone responds in Coptic, respond in Arabic, someone responds in Arabic. The Pope comes in front of the church, he makes matanya and the start continues ma'alim. The disciple of the Pope and his driver, they start looking who was respond. So look under the chair, nothing. One of them went to the altar to see where is this person, we hear him respond, nothing. The Pope start the mass and finish and on the car. The driver asked the Pope Corollos, Bob, did you hear the guy who responded to the ma'alim? He said, yes. He said, we looked inside. We looked in the altar. We looked everywhere we can find him. The Pope start laughing. He told him, what? He said, you remember when we say the angel of the tazbah, remember us? It was the angel. Because the ma'alim, he can't do it all by himself. God sent the angel to respond. The ma'alim blind, he can't see who responds. Someone responding and very happy talk to him. And so the church of God, the place of God and the place of angel. Last point, the church of God, the place of saints. If we go upstairs the heaven and we see the saints, we must see them here. Because here is the heaven on the earth, our church. This story happened. I tell you two stories about Saint Church and we'll finish. Beautiful story. First story, one of the priests went to the monastery. This monastery is called Monastery of Saint George in Old Egypt or Old Cairo. You know, to build any room or anything in the Egypt, very, very stressful by the government, they have to get approved and all stuff. So Abuna said, I wanted to visit this monastery, and the police outside the monastery, they got the bricks, they got the cement, they got everything, but he not allowed them to build anything. So when I come to bring a nun to one of the nuns, told them, Abuna, you are a man, talk to them, because we nun, they very rude and rough, they swear at us all the time. So Abuna went outside to talk to them. They told him, can you let us please to build the rest of the room and we'll finish with all the stuff. They said, you do this, you do that, you're not allowed. He said, he was very rude. I told him, thank you very much, I want to understand. I told the nun, the head of nun, listen, I try, it looks like a big problem, I just need to pray and go. You know, that's what I want. He said, I went to the all the church to pray. I found one of the nun who was praying with tears. And she started to tell him and the priest to preach of St. George, it's all my fault. I know you stopped the job because my fault. All this because I didn't do Rosie Blavan for you. He said, Rosie Blavan, he stopped praying and looked to her. He said, I know it was my fault. I know I was tired. But believe, let them start to build and I make you Rosie Blavan. He said, this man must be something wrong, you know. So Abuna stopped and looked to her, and she started telling him, please, just let them start the first break, and I do the rest of the blood. Abuna prayed and come out. He coming out, he found the officer, high officer from the police, telling him, please, start the bill, and I want you someone to sign for me here, I allow you to build. So Abuna told him what happened. He said, just now we got a phone call from the prime minister to say, start to build. Third away. So Abuna started to ask this nun what happened. She said, I was promised St. George. Every day this worker work, I have to do Rosh Hashanah for all of them, so they built your room. But yesterday I went to the bed very tired. When I went to bed very tired, I didn't do the Rosh Hashanah, that's why the job stopped. But now I promised him I do the Rosh Hashanah, so he gets the job too. Come on, man, we have to do the rose and water and the milk, and we start to do the rose with Laban, and the job will start to do. To show you that his house, he hear you. And when you do his job, when you promise something, you do. So that's the house of God, house of angel, house of saint. Another story about St. George, and we'll finish in this story. In olden days, the small village, do you know all the village have one priest, and this village have governor, and most of the governor, he walked with his horse and got 3-4 bodyguards around him. So this governor was walking, and he found a priest going to do the priest part. So afternoon, he told the priest, you, where you go? He said, I go to the church. I said, what you doing in the church? He said, I pray. He said, does anyone pray now, 5-6 o'clock? He said, yeah, we pray. So the governor, he clapped the priest on his face, the priest, his head full in the ground, and he full in the ground, and all his clothes with dust. Shaykh, at least we speak about respect the church, okay? So he clapped the priest, his head full down, he full down, all his clothes, dust, and everyone start laughing. The priest, he take his hat and went to the church. He was the servant of St. George for 28 years. And he stand in front of the bishop of St. George. I said, listen, I serve you for 28 years and you make this to happen to me and everyone else to love, and you know, small village, everyone he will know. How I can walk now? How I can do my job? How people respect me now? Listen, you have to do something. He done the Ashaya and was crying and very upset and back home. When he was back home, he found the house of this government all screaming. So he think, come on, pass away or something, you know, small village. He said, I go comfort them or anything. He told them what happened. He said, after the government slap you, we found a big soldier on his horse. And he come, he talked to him. You gave my servant something, I have to give it to you back. And he slapped the government in his face. But the slap of St. George was different. After he slapped him, he fell in the ground, he come up, he found one eye was blocked out. And St. George told him, remember, that's my servant, he never come close to him. So again, the church, the house of God, house of angel, house of saint, and whatever we see here, when we go up, we will see up. So what our job as a deacon, Our job as a deacon, I be very happy when I see the deacon coming from outside and come worship in front of the altar. If the Pope here, before you greet the Pope, you must greet God. He's the Pope God and my God and your God. The church teach us, before you talk to anyone, before you do anything, come worship in front of altar and talk to him. Number two, the clothes we wear as a suitable clothes for the church. Must be a suitable clothes for the church. Number three, what we're doing in our hair nowadays. I don't know what to have been honest. People now, they're not respecting the church. And that's a very dangerous sign. If you're not teaching the young generation how they respect the church, it's not respect. I was serving with Amba Athanasius here, and just someone talking to the altar. Do you know what he told him? He told him, that's why God, he not hear our prayer. Because he still praying and someone talking to the altar. We're not allowed to talk in the altar at all. At all. Just to talk by sign. And nowadays we have nice system, when we'll be in the altar, everyone have turn. So no one talk. Even outside here, the side here or the side there. We have altar this side, we have altar this side, we have altar this side. We are responsible to teach the people how they respect the church and the altar. If you're wearing a tonia and the people outside see you talking inside, do you think they can respect the church or the altar? If the deacon do this, why you tell us don't do it? So you have to be very careful. The more you know, the more you be judged. Don't be happy you have the tonia. You will be one day in front of God, will ask you, I gave you this talent. What did you do? We doesn't need quantity, we need quality. I'll not have 100 deacons here, and when Abuna have mass during the week, he can find someone to run the church in the mass, inside or outside. That's why you have responsibility to learn al-Ahkam, to read it as bah. How many hours we spending in front of BSP or games or whatever, and how many hours our job as a deacon we spend to learn something new. Anyone who learned some hymns or Alhan music here, can you put your hand up? What did you learn this year? Very good. What did you learn this year? Very good. Very good. Who else? Imagine yesterday. Very good. Do you see the rest? If you every year you learn something new, give yourself 5-6 years, you know. You will know. Give every year something, or every month you try to read something, or read about what the deacon. The deacon is very important, share a job in the church. So, we come in the church, we're respecting the church because that's the house of God, house of angels, house of the saint. We come, we worship in front of the altar, we keep the sitara, take the blessing, and we stand. No talking. Get your book or have a look to the screen and the full and the scene. And imagine if one day like these three boys, you come to the church, Abuna can't find any deacons. Until you come with me inside or Michael stay outside. You can laugh. I don't think it can be good. You've been 10 years deacon and you don't know how to run one man. Or tazbaha, sometimes we can't find anyone to do tazbaha. And that's a very important job for us. Alright, any question before I finish? Alright, thank you for having me today. Have a nice camp. God bless you and pray for me. Glory be to God forever and ever. Amen. Thank you.
Boys, I'm sure you don't have any questions, because I'm almost close to standards. Yes, there were some questions.
What happens if you're in the altar, and you know how it goes around, like that?
Does it show you?
You don't know what.
Well, we're going to take you.
And the guy.
I'll tell you something. There's different between you don't know, and you doesn't want to know. If you come ask Michael or ask anyone how many rounds I do, or what I do, And you see me, you see Manuel, you see Uncle Fair, all the big people. For when a new deacon, what we do? We will go with him, we count with him. But the problem, no one won't admit he doesn't know. Everyone is thinking he knows. But if you ask, everyone will help you. Because we are one team, all we have our purpose to serving him, God. Okay, yes, it's yours. I tell you something. I saw the photo. Don't forget, in part of the brain, the man, you have to take some of the blood to put it in. Okay, but again, if true or not true, what's the benefit for me? That can be body and the blood of Jesus Christ. If you can see it or not see it, it's still that body of blood of Jesus Christ. Nowadays, people, they look for photo, they look for miracles, they look for anything, but the aim, what's the aim? To come, and I believe that the body and blood of Jesus Christ, when I have him, I should be following his commandments and to be like his children. Any question?
Thank you very much.
All right. Okay, thank you very much. God bless you and pray for me.